Hello! In this WAGO tutorial, we show you how to configure a PFC as a Modbus TCP master in CODESYS 3.5, how to operate a Modbus coupler on it as a slave, and how to establish communication with the connected input and output modules. In this setup, we start with a PFC 200, and in this special case, we only set the end module on it. Then we have a 750/362 Modbus coupler with a power terminal plugged into it, then a 4-channel digital input module, a 2-channel analog input module, a 4-channel digital output module, a 2-channel analog output module, and of course the end module at the end of the Fieldbus node. Now we assign an IP address to the PFC with WAGO Ethernet settings and the WAGO USB service cable in the same subnet of our PC, and repeat the process with the coupler. Since the PFC and the coupler are not yet connected to the switch, the currently used column is still empty. Once the IP addresses have been assigned, we connect the PFC and the coupler to the switch. This prepares the structure, and we open the CODESYS 3.5 development environment in the Service Pack 18 Patch 2 version, since firmware 24 is installed on the PFC. We create a new project, assign a project name, select the standard project template, look for the connected PFC 8212 in the device list, confirm with OK, and wait until the project is open. With a double click on device, the communication window opens and we scan the network. Our controller is displayed and we connect to it. The communication to the controller is now established and we log out again. We can now attach a new device by right-clicking on device. The Add Device window opens and we select in the Fieldbus tree under Ethernet adapter, Ethernet. Ethernet is now displayed on the left. We click on it, and in the Add Device window that is still open, we select and attach the Modbus TCP master in the Modbus tree. The Modbus master is displayed. We click on it and then attach the Modbus TCP slave to it. Now in the 3S version, the Add Device and Device window can be closed. Now we have to determine on which IP address the PFC and the coupler can be reached and establish communication between the two. The PFC should communicate as a Modbus TCP master via the Ethernet interface. So we double click on Ethernet and search for the network interface with the controller IP address using the Browse button. Double clicking on Modbus TCP slave opens the slave tab, and we enter the slave IP address here, i.e. that of our coupler. With this, we have completed the communication settings, and we log in as a test. Now we have to define the slave channels, so we log out and want to define the channels. The channels are managed in the Modbus TCP slave tab under the Modbus slave channel tab. We add a new channel and the Modbus channel window opens. One possibility of channel assignment is that each module is assigned to its own channel, depending on its installation position. It is also recommended to access digital signals with coil functions and analog signals with register functions. Here is a small graphic to illustrate this. If digital signals as well as analog signals are read or written via register functions, the address area of the digital signals follows the analog signals. If further analog modules were to be added, the address range of the digital signals would be shifted. In order to avoid this, the digital signals are given the coil functions and we have them in a separate address range. At our first position is a 4-channel digital input module. So we assign the name DI01-402, select the coil function under access type read discrete inputs function code 2 and enter 4 as length for 4 digital inputs and confirm with OK. Next one is the analog input module. We assign the name AI01466 and select the function code 3 read hold in registers. The length is 2 because the module has 2 analog inputs. In this way, we also create the outputs. First, the digital outputs with function code 15, write multiple coils with a length 4, and the analog outputs with a function code 16, write multiple registers and length 2. Now the four channels also appear in the I/O mapping of the Modbus TCP slave, and we assign variables to the channels. We have now fully configured the Modbus master and slave and can now use the input and output modules in the development environment. Here are two short examples. If we equate digital input 1 with digital output 4 and apply a true signal to input 1, output 4 is activated. Or we have connected 789904 to the first analog input and the analog output. Now we divide the analog input value by 2 and assign the result to the analog output.